Courts are reluctant to impose liability on public authorities. In X versus Bedfordshire County Council, court said that the statutory system to prevent abuse involved a number of different agencies, including local authorities, the police, the education authority, etc. And to make one liable would be unjust. To impose a duty on all of them would make it impossible to determine whether one was liable. Therefore, the defendant was not liable. This was justified in the case of Gorringe versus Calverdale. Substantial claims for the compensation will lead to the taxpayers' money being diverted away from the general expenditure on public services. Policy issues are not justiciable. Courts are not equipped to adjudicate on public bodies. Policy decisions to provide one service instead of another. This led to policy distinction. The danger of liability will lead to defensive practices. They may be overcautious and not act for the public benefit in order to minimize the risk of tort liability. Maladministration by public bodies can be remedied in other ways. Example, breach of statutory duty claims, complaints to the Parliamentary Ombudsman, etc. In Dorset, the authority was liable in negligence for allowing the boys to escape, but could never have been liable for policy of allowing Bossel boys to work on the island. In Stowen versus Wise, Lord Hoffman held the distinction between the policy and the operations is an inadequate tool which was to discover whether the inappropriate to impose a duty of care, because the distinction is often elusive in practice. The distinction was subsequently revived by the House of Lords in Barrett versus Enfield. Lord Slynn stated, "The greater the element of policy involved, the wider the area of discretion accorded. The more likely is that the matter is not justifiable, so no action is brought in negligence." The distinction now plays a relatively minor role in deciding whether a public authority owes a duty of care. One factor in deciding whether a decision is justiciable. It is now more common to limit public authority liability on the basis of other factors. Example, Capero test. It is clear that the authorities owe a duty of care in relation to their positive operational acts. Example, Rigby versus Chief Constable. Police driver owed a duty of care in relation to the other road users or pedestrians. Furthermore, in Gorringe versus Calverdale, it was held that the authorities are subject to the same test for duty of care as private bodies. The mere existence of a statutory power duty to act cannot give rise to a duty of care in negligence. It is understandable where the authority has assumed responsibility for C's safety. They will generally be liable for omissions, but the court will still consider fair, just and reasonable rule. Are authorities under a duty to protect claimant from the harm caused by a third party? There are two key categories for cases here. First, police failing to prevent third party from harming claimant. Second, an ambulance failing to save claimant who was injured previously by third party. Police are generally not liable for third party harming claimant, whereas an ambulance comes under a duty to help the claimant and will be liable for failing to aid. In Kent versus Griffiths, a claimant suffered an asthma attack. Ambulance took 40 minutes to arrive. As a result, the claimant suffered brain damage. It was held that the ambulance owed a duty of care to the claimant. The key issue is assumption of responsibility. By answering a 999 call, the ambulance assumes responsibility toward the injured person. Furthermore, it is fair, just and reasonable because it will encourage the ambulance service to properly perform their core service. Whereas the police and the other public bodies will generally not be under a duty of care to take the positive action to protect claimant from injury by third party, unless they have 1. Clearly assumed responsibility for the claimant in respect to their safety, which requires more than a 999 call. 2. They have assumed control over the third party and should have foreseen third party would cause harm in the close proximity. In Hill versus Chief Constable, there was insufficiently proximate relationship between the police and the conduct and potential victims. The police only knew a broad class of people would be affected by the failure to catch the killer, to no nexus to a specific victim. Further, it was not fair, just and reasonable because liability may have a chilling effect on the police.